this other two, because one of them's in a big box. Thank you.
If I had to title this message today, I would title it "To Die Is Gain." And I'm going to give you a couple of quick scriptures, and we'll go through this. And the first scripture I want to read is 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse number 13. And it says, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope." The next scripture is going to be out of Philippians. And I'll be reading verse number 21. "For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. To those who do not believe in God, life on earth is the best there is. For the non-Christian, it's not only natural to strive for the world's values and money, popularity, power, and prestige. For the Christian, it's different. To die is gain. What do we gain? We gain a better body, a glorified, immortalized, resurrected body. In this present body of clay, we are subject to all the sorrows and tears that life brings. Age, sickness, and finally death is inevitable. End of this house made from the dust of the earth. But in death and the resurrection, we gain a better body, one that can never grow old, knows no disease, never suffers pain, and can never die. We gain a better body. The next thing that we gain a better home. However, the beauty and the embellishments of any house we may possess in this world, it is nothing compared with our mansion in the beautiful city of God. Look at the promise of the Lord in John chapter 14, verses number 1 through 3. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." The longing of the Apostle Paul for his home in heaven is expressed in Philippians 1 and 23. "For I am straight betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far more better." We gain a better inheritance. Our final reward is not here, it's in heaven. We gain a better fellowship. All of us live in this world of a dissolving family circle. Mother is gone, father is gone, or a child is gone, or beloved grandparents are gone, or a close friend is gone. But the circle is unbroken in heaven forever and ever. There is no death there, no sorrow, no crying, no pain, for these former things are passed away, and Jesus is there. If for me to live is Christ, then to die is gain. If for me to live is money, then to die is loss. If for me to live is self, then to die is loss. If for me to live is ambition, then to die is loss. If for me to live is sin, then to die is loss. But if for me to live is Christ, to die is gain.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved. Blind, but now I see. bright shining as the sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
Let's pray. Lord, we just come before you now, Lord. We at the end of this service, Lord, we know that to die is gain because we know that Rhonda was saved, Lord. So we just thank you that you have already received her into your arms. Lord, we thank you that she is walking in the streets of gold. God, we thank you that she has received her glorified body and her new life. And Lord, we will miss her down here on this earth, Lord, but we just come before you now, Lord. We thank you that you be with the family and the friends, Lord, in the times to come that's difficult, Lord. And we just give you the honor and the glory. And, Lord, just be with us on this day in Jesus' name. Amen.